for the crowd. That's a good hit.
Forget what I said about them making certain they stay there in the last over. It's a wonderful 50 partnership. Taken some stick here. .277/7. Good shot. Wonderful stroke. Great over. Terrific entertainment. It's brought the crowd to their feet. And that over, 1-1-2-4-4-4. Brilliant stuff. 37 to Philip DeFratis and 25 to Darren Goff. And a standing ovation. Absolutely brilliant and wonderfully enjoyable for the big crowd here at Capacity House at the Oval, with 37 for Philip DeFratis and 25 for Darren Goff in that unbroken partnership that took them through to stumps. 281/7, terrific effort there. 62 for Stewart, who played very well. 79 for Graham Thorpe, who's confirmed that he is a top-notch player. And Graham Hick, 39. The bowling figures for the South Africans, they took some stick towards the end. Donald, 3/76 from 17. De Villiers got through twice, but still had 55 taken from 16. Picked up 3 wickets in all. Matthews, 1/66. And both McMillan and Hansi Cronje went wicketless. So at the end of the second day's play of this third Cornhill Test match between England and South Africa, the South Africans 332 all out early in the day, England 281/7, England 51 runs behind.
It's first on BBC One, highlights of an exciting third day in the third Test, introduced by Richie Beno.
Problems continue for England cricket captain Michael Atherton. Yesterday, match referee Peter Burge slugged him with a £1,500 fine and a severe reprimand for what he saw as dissent with the first ball LBW decision given by Ken Palmer. Following the Lords controversy, Atherton's hold on the England captaincy has been queried in many quarters. My own view is that Burge's fine was harsh, but not unfair in the light of things that have happened earlier in the summer, and that Atherton should certainly stay on as captain. Well, that was yesterday. Welcome to today. This is the third day of the Cornhill Test match at the Oval between England and South Africa. We've had two very good days of cricket. And this day begins with Philip DeFratis and Darren Goff picking up where they left off in their stirring battle yesterday, where they took England to within 51 runs of the South African first innings score. That's the way it is, 281/7 at the start of this third day. DeFratis 37, Goff 25, and it was absolutely brilliant to watch at Capacity House here, and they all appreciated it very much. We join play now with Matthews bowling to Goff. It's the second over of the day, and 4 runs have been added to the overnight total.
Good. A tremendous psychological blow for England if they were able to get a first innings lead. the ball calls. The crowd has come in very quickly on that. They knew what was happening.
Well, it's all running for Darren Goff and Phil De Freitas this morning, as it was last night. The crowd loved it. Just when they thought he might be out, it's a no ball.
Well done. That's going to be one for the third umpire. And it was very, very close. Looked to me to be a bit of a struggle for Philip De Freitas.
Yeah, a very quick feeling from cover. Came in, didn't try to throw it, went underarm. So he can release the ball quicker. And you can see in the picture, Phil De Freitas is struggling to make it. It's going to be tight. Gone. He's out.
.292 for 8 now. Oh, that's close, yes. There's no doubt about that. And Joey Benjamin knew it. He was on his way almost before Ken Palmer raised his finger. Don't often see a batsman walk for an LBW decision.
Well, this was an easy one to give for Kenny Palmer. Ball just swung in just a touch, maybe, just angled in. This old ball never really got forward, never got out of the crease, Joey Benjamin. Hits him round about off stump and he's trying to play right across it to leg.
That's going to be over-disturbing for the fielding side to see Devon Malcolm coming out to replace Joey Benjamin. Devon gave Farnie de Villiers a couple when he batted. And there's the reply. Good morning, Devon. You see most things in cricket over the years, but don't see too many fast bowlers call for a new helmet after facing one ball. Union the other day for talking about an agricultural stroke, but not much else fits the bill there.
Well, it just makes me laugh, does Darren Goff. It's as if he's playing for Barnsley in the Yorkshire League against Castleford or Scarborough. Doesn't make any difference to him that he's playing a test match against South Africa. Merv Hughes.
Gone there. That's well bowled by Matthews. Slower ball. Devon Malcolm didn't pick it. And the innings finishes at 304.
That's a very good performance from England to get within 28 runs of the South African total, 304 they made. Lovely run out, lovely piece of work from Darryl Cullinan there to get De Freitas for 37. Joey Benjamin, after his 4-wicket debut, made naught, and Devon Malcolm, the last man out for 4. But 42 not out for Darren Goff, and very, very valuable runs they are. The England tail hasn't always wagged in recent years, but it certainly did here and has done in other matches this summer. The bowling figures for South Africa, Donald 3 for 76, wasn't used today. De Villiers 4 for 62, Matthews 2 for 82, and McMillan and Cronier, neither of those made the bowling crease either. So the state of the game, as South Africa begin their second innings, England 304, having chased 332, 28 runs behind, and the South Africans have a bonus today because Jonty Rhodes was at the ground and he will be able to bat if needed. We join the South African innings now. It's the start of the second over. Evan Malcolm is the bowler, Gary Kirsten taking strike. No runs on the board as yet.
Ferocious in the first delivery.
This is one of the best opening deliveries of a spell I've seen for some time. And just look how far Devon Malcolm follows through. He's on his way down there. He gets to within two or three paces of Gary Kirsten by the time he's finished. Beautifully directed, quick, very, very hostile. I think Devon means business.
Ouch! Corton bowled him. Well, Kirsten was turned inside out in those three deliveries. What a start for England. And Gary Kirsten completes a very poor match with the bat. Not often Devon Malcolm rushes to take a catch.
That blow to the head, I think, has done more than just shake Devon Malcolm up. It's turned into real inspiration. There's venom in his bowling now, and as Jack Bannister says, look where Devon Malcolm took that catch. Again, the follow-through. Look at the celebration. Now here comes the next target.
Well, Hansie Cronier, and I think he will be targeted. If Headingley showed himself to be shaky against the short stuff. Unconvincing. Got him. Well, Peter Kirsten, a second failure. Caught by Philip DeFreitas and two wickets for Devon Malcolm. And that is an authentic quick bowler's dismissal.
Good fortune as far as England are concerned is that it went close enough. Philip DeFreitas down at long leg to take a good catch. A sprawling catch. Had to move very quickly down there, try and set himself as the ball arrived. Might not have been the cleanest of catches, but it stayed in. That's all you need.
He's come in at some tricky moments in this series. Nothing approaching this. One run for two wickets. Bowled him. Pitched it up. Got his reward. A miserable match for Cronier. What a sight. Stumps awry. Three wickets for Malcolm. One for three.
In a way, you can't blame Hansie Cronier for being just a fraction late coming forward. He does like to get on the front foot. Not only did Devon Malcolm get that ball on the perfect length, he got it just to come back in a little bit as well, to beat the defensive shot.
Darryl Cullinan.
That's a beautiful stroke. Quick to seize on that. Upfield is quicken up again after rain has disappeared, or the rain that got on the outfield yesterday.
Oh, that's a big shout. Hit the bat first, I think. There was a bit of a noise on the bat. That's why England were appealing. No real sort of footwork at all. Got stuck in his crease. That nipped back a lot.
Oh, that's a cool shot. Got away with it. Dear me.
round the wicket. Nearly worked as well.
It did, the angle and the pace. It was a very quick delivery.
Got him. It's worked. It nearly did the ball before. And that might just be the crucial breakthrough. Vessels goes for 28. 73 for 4.
Well, it was very thoughtful bowling from Devon Malcolm to try around the wicket when nothing was working from over the wicket. But what a dreadful shot to get out to with his country in this position. Look how wide this is, the feet are miles away from the line of the ball.
New batsman, Brian McMillan.
That's up in the air. Gucci's under it. And drops it. Hands you would think were so very safe, a head so experienced. High on the bat, McMillan. Gucci gets in a good position and then hardly lays a hand on it. Goes straight through. Hits him on the chest.
Mr. Frederister Cullinan.
A good stroke.
Half century for Darrell Cullinan. 52 not out. And just 81 balls faced. So this is only a saver for South Africa, but for him as well. A lovely shot, particularly for a man with only one hand. Two hands, but only one that's working.
Caught him. Caught him. Graham Thorpe, the end of McMillan. I have to say, affected by that bruised finger. Very tentative shot, gone for 25. And that's 137 for 5.
This is definitely Devon Malcolm's day. Short, banged in, quick, and really just guided into Graham Thorpe's hands at first slip. Nicely taken.
Devon Malcolm. So there might just have been a little bit of swing there. Almost 42 overs old.
Very little doubt about that. That's knocking out middle and leg stumps. No hesitation from umpire Palmer. New batsman in Craig Matthews, which indicates that Jonty Rhodes is sliding further and further down the order.
Great catch by Steve Rhodes. Wonderful piece of cricket there. One of the most fiery deliveries you'll see in a long, long time. And a brilliant piece of work by the England wicketkeeper, Stephen Rhodes. Matthews got a touch and also got a pair.
Lethal delivery.
And a fine catch.
Two wickets. First over after tea brings Jonty Rhodes to the wicket.
It was a good shot. Beautiful spread. ...154 for 7. Good shot. Really well all day long. Came in critical circumstances, Darrell Cullinan, and has played wonderfully. We've seen him bat on a number of occasions, and anything that's short, Rhodes will roll his wrist on it. Some wonderful strokes in that fashion.
That's the lead of 200. That gets Darrell Cullen in there. It's in three figures. Cracking pull.
Yes, it was. 203 runs ahead now, but it was such a good shot. Watch how he gets his foot right across. His body gets over. Gets right over to the offside. Pulls it down.
Short of three figures, caught by Graham Thorpe, and Darren Goff finally breaks his duck for this match. First wicket, and 175 for eight.
Well, a lot of disappointment for Darrell Cullinan. I'd expect that. He plays wonderfully well in a difficult situation for him after a failure in the first innings. His team in big trouble. It's a sad and disappointing way to end when he was so near to a century.
The batsman Fowley de Villiers.
Those figures, 7 for 57. Terrific performance. Outstanding pace all day. Hostility, he's made all of the batsmen jump and hop around.
For Devon Malcolm, another catch for Rhodes to get rid of Rhodes. 175 for nine.
Well, not the best shot at all, that, just wafting away outside off stump. There have been some pretty poor shots played by the South Africans. Mike Proctor will know that. The players will know it themselves. Quite a bit of sympathy for Jonty Rhodes on that knock on the head, but not much sympathy from Devon Malcolm in England. They'll be thrilled a bit. They don't mind what sort of shot he plays as long as he gets out. 8 wickets for Devon Malcolm. What an incredible performance. Superb performance.
That brings Alan Donald into bat. It really is the last chance saloon for South Africa. Englishman to get nine in England was Jim Laker. What a performance. Bowled off his pad. All out for 175 and to win the game and square the series. England won 204.
Well, Alan Donald's not much of a batsman, but bowled Devon Malcolm not. I must say, it's an outstanding performance by Devon Malcolm. An exciting performance as well. Brought life to the crowd and everybody that supports England, and put England on the brink of winning this test match. Yes, smiled Devon. Terrific figures, 9 for 57. Totally deserved.
Only Jim Laker for England has had better figures this century.
That's a terrific effort from England to bowl out South Africa for 175. Just the two wicket takers there, Malcolm and Goff. And Darrell Cullinan, special mention for him. 94, he came into the side as a replacement for Andrew Hudson. 28 to Vessels, 25 to McMillan, and 10 to Rhodes, who came in very low in the order. The bowling figures for England, Malcolm, 16.3 overs, two maidens, and 9 for 57. A wonderful effort from him. The fourth best bowling ever for England. Only Jim Laker has better figures this century. Situation is that England required 204 runs to win. We join their innings now on the fourth ball. Donald is the bowler to Gooch, and already there are two runs, both no balls, on the scoreboard.
That's away. Dropped him.
and of all people, McMillan.
Well, that's what usually happens. England have blown South Africa away today in the form of Devon Malcolm, and now the luck's staying with them. And those are very welcome runs indeed. Off the thick outside of the back, down for four. Again, a fine away swinger bowled by Fine de Villiers. Her runs are really flowing. Terrific start. The crowd right behind England. It's been a sensational afternoon. Devon Malcolm is 9 for 57. That's a fine shot, a thumping straight drive. It was in fact a no ball, but firmly met by Graham Gooch. Well, he clatters it. A pretty brutal shot, a little unorthodox.
It's almost a touch of Darren Goff in this. Not that Graham Gooch would be pleased to hear that.
Well, there's no man at mid on. Let's hit it there. That England are going for the runs tonight. Four runs, beautifully played. Well, the ball asked for it. It's over pitched up on next stump. And now surely the slip peelers have to come out. There have been three slip peelers there from the start, and sure enough, one is on the way.
Well, Fine de Villiers is asking this ball to do too much. At a time when he and all the South African bowlers, only two used so far, of course, just need to be concentrating on keeping the flow of runs down, then no one can afford just to drift down towards leg stump like that. That's a strong area for batsmen like this.
That's another one drifting down next side, and Alan Doyle gives up chase. Well, this is now becoming as remarkable as extraordinary performance of England in the field. Thank you very much. That was a long hop. Graham Gooch played that well because he just waited an extra bit for it. They know the signal now, those young boys. And the 50 comes up. Well, it's like a Sunday league match, this. This is Gooch in Chelmsford mode. Bowling straight to the gate, and that faintly pleases Craig Matthews. Certain absence of footwork, but that's a hurricane contribution by Graham Gooch.
Well, finally South Africa finding the response. An off-cutter from Craig Matthews. Graham Gooch not in position to deal with it.
Full of character, full of thundering strokes. And it's given England an excellent start. And introduces Graham Hick with a score 56 for 1.
Nice stroke. Beautiful play by Atherton. We're in the seventh over of the innings and the score already is 62. Beautifully timed and placed there by the England captain. Wonderful stroke. A real asset.
Striking the ball slightly on the rise. Beautiful stroke.
Three strokes in the last two overs. Two of them off the front foot, and that one, a beautiful stroke off the back foot.
The stroke of the highest quality. The ball just a little bit short of a length, but the width allowed him to hit right through it. Beautiful positioning. Right foot parallel with the crease. Launched himself at the ball. Hit it close to him. Great shot.
So a wonderful stroke. He's in good touch, the England captain. A very good shot. Didn't time it quite as well as one or two others that have been played, but it has still beaten the fielder into the boundary. So majestic. That was only shortish. And Donald has taken some awful stick here.
That was stirring stuff, 107 for just one wicket. Graham Gooch out bowled by Matthews for 33. Atherton, 42, played some glorious strokes. And Hick, well, typical of his stroke play was that last one you saw. Five extras, 107 for one. And the bowling figures for South Africa, Donald, four overs, no maiden, none for 45. He's had 75 taken from the last six overs he's bowled in this match. De Villiers, none for 40 from seven. Matthews, the wicket taker, at a cost of 21. And five overs and no maiden for him. So the state of play after 3 days of this Cornhill Test match, South Africa 332 all out and 175. England 304 and 107 for one. They need 97 more runs to win. The key to it today was Malcolm on that second lot of figures there, 9 for 57. And I had the pleasure of talking with him after the day's play.
From the beginning, I had to let them know, well, I'm in business here. I didn't want to start off with a half volley, whatever, something like that. So I said, okay, you got to sniff the first ball. And which was pretty close. And you know, from the ball of first ball, got you with a bit of pace. And I said, okay, I reckon I've got him where I want him now. And a few balls later, I was ducking. And as it happened, he ducked into one straight up in the air. Cotton ball, plan starts. It's working fine, so just continue.
Very nice plan. Was it brought about in part by the blow you took from Farnie de Villiers?
Well, yes, you could say that. I mean, you know, I thought it was a silly thing for Farnie to do, trying to knock my head off. He hit me nicely, yes, but I had a good helmet on, and no problem. I take my blows, say to the boys, your turn will come, and, took some, taking some wickets, so very happy indeed.
And it still looked very smooth towards the end, even though you must have been tiring towards the end, but still coming out of your hand pretty well.
Yes, I mean, I've bowled some long spells this year. I've been bowling well. I'm fit. So no problem. I said, when you're doing well as well, you just, I don't know where the energy and the strength come from, but you're just feeling better and better the more you bowl. But, it's one of those things. And, felt well, and feeling pretty strong.
You've caught the attention of the South Africans today. I'll bet you've caught the attention of some of the Australians watching and listening back there. Good luck when you go down there to Australia. You've been there before?
I've been there before, but I really look forward. I hope I'll be on the tour in the winter. So, keeping my fingers crossed anyway. I will be in that party.
Good luck and a brilliant performance today. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Jim.
Devon Malcolm, the hero of England's performance out there today. And the other one was Michael Atherton, who's under tremendous pressure, led the side splendidly, got the bowlers going, and the fielding was absolutely brilliant. And I should think he has quite a smile on his face this evening. The fourth day of this Cornhill Test match at the Oval, BBC One at 10:55. We'll be with you, bringing you all the action there. And we leave you now on the third evening with Devon Malcolm, one of the most wonderful bowling performances you'll see in a long, long time.